Hey guys, so in this video I'm going to be showing you my skincare routine. It's really simple, really basic. This is what I do on an everyday basis. I do it at night also. I really don't change it up. So I don't know if you guys actually would want to see a nighttime routine because it would be the same thing that I do day and night. I use basic products, Cetaphil, and drugstore products. They're all drugstore. And they work perfectly for acne-prone skin because I used to struggle with acne. If you look at one of my few first videos, kind of awkward, obviously, because I was barely starting, but I used to use Murad, and you could see, I think you could see most of my acne that I had going on. I think, I'm not sure. I don't really remember the quality of that video. I think it was really crappy, but you could go ahead and check that out. I will put the links to all the products. I'm sure you could get them on Amazon because I bought one of the products there. And what can't you find on Amazon? So I will link them down below. If not, I will just put a list of the products that I use. And that is it. I hope you try it out if you have acne-prone skin. And let me know if it works for you. So what I did already was wash my face with the Daily Facial Cleanser from Cetaphil, however you say this. I use this one. It's the one from normal to oily skin because I have combination skin. So I wash my face in the shower because your pores are open. Obviously, you could do it when you're out of the shower. Then I scrubbed my face today. I do this every other day, if not at least twice a week. So I use the St. Ives Fresh Skin Apricot Scrub, but for best results, you know, just scrub off your face, not your literally your face, but all that dead skin. It's recommended to use 3 to 4 times a week, and it's just this one, and it exfoliates your skin. It has little beads. So the scrub, I usually use it when I'm in the shower because my pores, everyone's pores open up, especially because of the warm water that's in the room. So it's I recommend using it in the shower. I really like to use it in the shower. So once I get out of the shower, I use this Dickinson's Original Witch Hazel, and it's the Pore Perfecting Toner. I use this to tone my face, and I get this at Rite Aid. I think you could also get it at, what's it called? At Walmart. That's where I usually see them. So I'm just going to get a round cotton pad and just basically clean my face. And you want to do this like going outwards, not really going in any kind of circular motion. And I'm just going to be toning my face. I could even go over my eyes. It helps to depuff your eyes. So notice how I'm just doing this to the outside of my face, going outwards, and then kind of also doing it on my neck. And I do this morning and night. So I let that soak into my skin, and while I'm letting that soak in, I'm going to apply some lip balm. Usually I use Carmex. Some of you might know that. I think I've mentioned that. But today I'm going to be using the lip butter from Nivea. It's the raspberry one, and I'm just gonna apply it on my lips because you can never neglect your lips. Obviously, they're on your face. If you're doing something to your face, you might as well just do it to your lips and your neck too. Never neglect your neck or your lips. So it feels like that is already set in, and now I'm gonna go ahead and use the Clean and Clear Persigel 10. And this is benzoyl peroxide. It's 5% benzoyl peroxide. Looks like that. And it's a white acne cream. It just looks like that. So even though I don't have any active breakouts, I'm just going to apply some on my nose. I have like a tiny little zit that wants to pop out. Apply some on my cheeks because that's where I usually get my breakouts. On my chin and a little bit on my forehead. And you want to go ahead and apply it as if you're applying lotion in a way, just to make sure that you don't get any pimples. And who wants pimples on their face? No one. No one wants pimples or zits. So now I let that set in and really soak into my skin. Usually what I do, if I want the process to be a little bit faster, I just go ahead and fan my face with my hands, and that really helps. So that is set in, and then I'm going to apply my Cetaphil Daily Advanced Lotion, and I used to use the different one, the one that was for normal to oily skin, and this is for dry and sensitive skin, which I like also, and it doesn't make me oily. So I just get like half a pump, literally all I need. Get a water book. And I'm gonna go like that, rub it together, kind of just like apply it on my face, like whatever, and then the rest apply it on my neck. And obviously we're not leaving this lotion like that, so I'm just gonna go ahead and start rubbing it into my skin. And you want to do it softly and gently, obviously, because it's your face. You could apply some underneath your eyes, and I usually do that with my ring finger because it's the most sensitive touch. And then whatever you have left over, just apply it onto your hands. That's what I do. And make sure that everything sets in. And I go over my skin more than once just to make sure that I got everything covered. And that is it. The main thing for preventing acne would be this bad boy. This is the Clean and Clear Persigil, and it's not even 5%, it's 10% benzoyl peroxide. I know that there's other brands that have this, but I swear by this. I've repurchased it so many times. I've been using it for a long time already, and it's what keeps my skin under control. So as long as you have a good face wash that removes your makeup, also would be the Cetaphil. I swear by this stuff. Also, having a good toner. This is specifically for acne skin. So, well, it doesn't say, but it gently cleanses and conditions pores to maintain clear, smooth, and balanced skin without over drying. Because there's a lot of toners that dry out your skin. I used to use toners, a different toner, and it would dry out my skin. I would have dry patches and stuff, and honestly, to apply makeup after, it would be a hassle. And it's all natural with Chasm. And then to moisturize your skin, obviously this, or I would also recommend the Proactive oil-free lotion, which I also really like, but it's kind of pricey. And yeah, that's basically all I do to my skin. So that is what I do on an everyday basis, like I said. I hope you guys liked this video. And if you want to see any other kind of routine, make sure to leave me a comment down below. And I will get back to that as soon as I have a chance to read your comment or get to the video. Because I always read your guys' comments. So that is it. I hope you guys liked it. And I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.